Well, let's see what the flag is going to be. That's number five, Chancey Simpson, on the receiving end of that touchdown. Rather, number five, Jason Cook, on the receiving end of that touchdown. And we do have the flag, and I've not yet seen it indicated yet. But it's going to be an offside call against the Gordon Longhorns, so we do have a touchdown for the Wynn Herald Panthers. And so with 8 minutes and 6 seconds to go, the Panthers are on the board first tonight. Off to attempt the extra point right now is Brandon Rogers. Ball is blocked at the 10-yard line. We'll have to move it all over the place. The flag fly before the ball is even snapped. Either the Longhorns were offside or they were drawn offside, I suppose. We'll wait and see what the official indication is. It's going to be an offside call again against the Longhorns, and they are perhaps a bit eager early in this ballgame. Randy, no, there's some butterflies out there.
Definitely, and you can see that, especially in defensive movement. They're trying to get back there too quickly. They've got to settle down, get the bearings about to play some football.
Here we go, there's the snap. The kick is up. It's short, and it goes to the left. The kicker is made by a pass from Michael Lopez to Jason Cook, who starts this ballgame off here today at the six-man state football championship. Wynn Herald 6, Gordon nothing, 8 minutes, 6 seconds to go in the first quarter. And Gordon should have their first opportunity to touch the ball. There's an onside kick. It falls inside the 30, and that was in the corner by Wynn Herald. It has been an onside kick. Does the Gordon Longhorns let go by the 30-yard line and come to the going out-of-bounds sprint? Has been recovered by Wynn Herald. Unbelievable. You can see it right off the bat what they were going to do. Gordon let the ball behind them, didn't really go through the ball quick enough. They had a great catch-up game, and now the Longhorns are going to have to stand back and kick the ball and throw it away to save right there.
My goodness, what a chain of events here early in the first quarter. Wynn Herald is going to get the football first and 15. And the ball is at the Gordon 25-yard line from the spread formation. Quarterback Justin Strachner has the ball. He finds out what it is. That comes to deep downfield. It's caught. It's caught for a touchdown. Unbelievable. Oh, my gosh. The Longhorns had a shot at him at about the 30. He avoided that and tossed the ball deep into the end zone. And Dockery comes up with it. There was some good coverage in the end zone by Joe Cosia, but the pass was absolutely perfect. And this is a very unfamiliar situation for the Gordon Longhorns.
There he is. That's going to play a big part right here. Gordon can get out of his hole. There's the staff to kick the extra point attempt again. It's wide by. That may be a good opener, let's say, for the Gordon Longhorns. As Wynn Herald has been unable to convert on either of their extra point attempts thus far. So our new score, with just 7 minutes 56 seconds to go in the first quarter, is now Wynn Herald 12 and Gordon nothing. And Brett, let's keep it right here. One of the interesting things we've been watching for just the last few minutes, there's the wind is trying to change directions here. We had a southerly breeze up until game time, and it looks now difficult to tell in a bowl situation, of course, with the wind swirling, but it looks like that wind may be switching around to a westerly direction, eventually to a northerly one. So we'll follow that as the game goes on. Here's another onside kick by Wynn Herald. This time it's recovered by Gordon inside their own territory at about the 39-yard line. Jim Costia picked that up right at the 39-yard line. Nice heads-up move for Gordon. And again, the lineup of the onside kick formation is totally confusing there for Gordon Longhorns. But that time, hey, he did a great job of picking it up. Gordon has some fantastic athletes. That's going to be put on that very first line to make sure the offside is in line again.
Well, that is Parson. Gordon Crowd is ready to see some offensive action from their side of the field. As Cosia brings his men up to the line of scrimmage, a tight formation, sign for in the backfield. Cosia going to throw it early on after Super Chamberlain at the 25-yard line and just overthrows him. Looks like Chamberlain may have had some problems getting off the line of scrimmage, and that's what these Gordon Crowd deals happen. Since we have a huge contingent from the city of Gordon, I don't know who they left Mike in the store in Gordon, Texas, or for that matter, with Harold. But in any case, just about everybody is here. We have a great crowd here at the Mustang Bowl.
People were making fun of us earlier for broadcasting for Gordon. We know we have a lot of fans that are Gordon fans, not to throw a lot of Westbrook everywhere else.
Second and 15, there's a good back to sideline. He changes directions, but it's on time.